The past 10 days, I've wanted to stick my head in an oven. But if I wait another week, I'm pretty sure Stephen Bannon will do it for me. Maybe Donald Trump would consider hanging himself to heighten my orgasm. Folks, American decency must be spinning in its grave right now. This travel ban, I'll tell you what, we'll give immigrants that test to determine whether or not they're Christian just as soon as Donald Trump can pass it. That is why, until Donald Trump is impeached, I, David Feldman, self-identify as Muslim. I am a Muslim now because religion is fluid. Yes, religion is fluid, much like Trump's face after the Russian hooker has finished urinating on it. Welcome to the broadcast. I'm David Feldman, davidfeldmanshow.com. Please friend me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter. I know we have Trump supporters listening to my show. I'm not trying to make you feel stupid. I'm just trying to make you feel uneducated. That's all. If you didn't graduate from high school, if you didn't go to college, don't feel stupid. Feel uneducated. I went to college, and when I got to college, I was unprepared, and I became an alcoholic and a pothead, and it took me 6 years to get through college. I was dropping in and dropping out, but one thing I remembered from college is I'm an idiot, and it's stuck with me forever, and I'm constantly trying to make up for the lost time in college, drinking and smoking and not going to class. So I've spent every day since I've been sober trying to learn what I should have learned in college. I recognize that I'm uneducated. I recognize that I'm stupid. I recognize that, yes, I have a college degree, but it's bogus because I learned how to write papers without even reading a book, and I got by on my BS abilities. But I know that I'm stupid, and I know that I'm uneducated. So I surround myself with people who can teach me. Surround yourself with people who are better than you, occasionally better than you. Surround yourself with people who know more than you do. Trump supporters don't do that because Trump won't do that. He surrounds himself with sycophants. He surrounds himself with Eric, Don Jr., Ivanka, and that idiot Jared Kushner, who I'll get to in a second. Don't resent somebody because they know something you don't know. Learn from them. Go back to what you were taught in elementary school. Your teacher knows something, so shut up, listen, and learn. Behave. Play well with others. Do everything you were taught in first grade, which is the complete opposite of everything Donald Trump represents. And the reason you voted for Trump, Trump supporters, is he doesn't make you feel stupid. When did having a lack of education become something to celebrate in this country? Probably under George W. Bush, who had to hide his Harvard MBA and his Yale diploma with a Texas drawl, that Texas twang, because people were threatened by Al Gore. What's wrong with being educated? We're here to educate you because I'm stupid. I'm an idiot. I'm a fraud. It's okay to be stupid and uneducated, as long as you're willing to shut up and listen. And that's the problem with me on this show. I talk too much. I know that. I'm trying to get better at it. So now we're banning Muslims, right? We're going into the second week. Call your congressman, peacefully protest, show up. It drives Trump and Bannon crazy. Trump is trying to ban Muslim refugees. But if those Muslim refugees, by the way, if they can somehow make it in here, they are free to go buy an assault weapon, right? No problem buying an assault weapon. We need to ban assault weapons, not Muslims. If you're on the no-fly zone in this country, you can still buy an assault weapon in America because the NRA is controlled by gun makers. Gun makers make money by killing you. Stephen James, who listens to my show, he made a meme for me. This is what he wrote, and he made it in a beautiful JPEG that I will post on Facebook and Twitter and over at my website. This is what the meme says. Since 1995, there have been 3,503 Americans killed by all terrorist attacks. Many of those dead were killed by Catholic and Christian terrorists. Since 1995, there have been over 256,000, wow, gun homicides. Let me read that again. Since 1995, there have been over 256,000 gun homicides. This number does not reflect the many thousands of self-inflicted gunshot suicides. Wow. Muslims are not the problem. If we are banning what threatens Americans, ban guns, not Muslims. Thank you, Stephen James. And I will post that, with his permission, to my website, and I will post it on Twitter and Facebook. Well, last week, Trump removed the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff and the director of national intelligence from the National Security Council. That is not a congressionally approved part of the White House. And he replaced these people with President Steve Bannon. Howie Klein, who's on the show all the time, says if you want to get Steve Bannon kicked out of the White House, always refer to him as President Steve Bannon, because Trump will fire him because of his ego. By the way, Dr. Joseph Goebbels, who was the Minister of Propaganda for Adolf Hitler, was kind of brilliant. The way that the Nazis went after their powerful opponents, publishers, industrialists, Jews, who held sway in the early years of Nazi Germany. Dr. Joseph Goebbels taught the Nazis not to attack these powerful people. He taught them to cut them off at their knees so they're alone and isolated. Don't go after the powerful people. Go after their underlings so that it gums up the works. Kind of genius. So you had these powerful industrialists and writers and bankers who didn't know that they were alone until it was too late. Genius. So my advice to people who want to save our republic is, yeah, it's good to attack Trump, but go after Steve Bannon. Start calling him President Steve Bannon. Start going after Ivanka. Go after Jared Kushner. Go after Kellyanne Conway. Too easy to go after Kellyanne Conway. But start cutting Trump off at the knees. So one day he just fires all these people because he's, you know, impulsive. He's prone to paranoia, or ruled by paranoia. And in 6 months, he's going to be all alone in the White House. Rince Priebus will be gone. They'll all be gone because he's insane. And he'll just be completely isolated. So it's important to go after Trump, but take a tip from your good friend, Dr. Joseph Goebbels. I'm serious here. I'm being absolutely serious. You got to take a page from the Dr. Joseph Goebbels playbook. Start going after President Bannon. That way, Trump will be all alone in the White House like Nixon, just on his knees, praying, talking to the portraits of the presidents like Richard Nixon. That's what we have to do. We can get we can impeach Trump, or we can get him to resign. Well, Steve Bannon now is going to be in the National Security Council. He is a chief strategist in the White House. He is going to be part of the National Security Council. The chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff won't be there. The director of national intelligence will not be there. Steve Bannon, President Steve Bannon, will be there. He has no government experience until now. He's never worked in intelligence. He's had no high-level military experience. He was in the Navy, and he ran the alt-right propaganda outlet known as Breitbart News. Their job is to push white nationalist, anti-Jew, anti-Arab propaganda. What's dangerous about this is it is the National Security Council, not the Pentagon, that authorizes all those secret targeted killings of American citizens overseas without due process. As Jim Earle calls it, the drone incinerations that go on, that comes out of the National Security Council. So Steve Bannon is going to be advising Trump in the National Security Council. We won't have the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff or the director of national intelligence. Rince Priebus said on the Sunday shows, well, they'll be invited, you know, if they want to come, but they don't sit on the National Security Council. So who is Steve Bannon? Well, you all know. I don't have to remind you who Steve Bannon is. In the Washington Post, it was reported that Steve Bannon is against foreign students who are studying here in America. He's against foreign students staying here after they get their degree. He wants them to go back to where they came from because he thinks it's wrong when, quote, two-thirds or three-quarters of the CEOs in Silicon Valley are from South Asia or from Asia. He says Asians should not be running Silicon Valley. Yeah. What's the stereotype? What's the vicious stereotype about Asians and Jews? So, that they're smart, that they're good at math, right? A white nationalist like Steve Bannon would propagate these kind of stereotypes that actually hurt Jews and actually hurt Asians because it creates jealousy and it creates the idea that they don't need help. They're so smart, you know, the super Jew, the super Asian, who needs to hire them? They have money. How could they possibly need me to hire them? That kind of prejudice actually hurts Asians and it hurts Jews. Friday was Holocaust Remembrance Day. The Holocaust, it is illegal to deny the Holocaust in Germany, in France, and Great Britain because in Europe, they knew that there's an element of society that over time will choose to rewrite history and come up with alternative facts. It's kind of controversial whether or not that is a violation of freedom of speech, but it is illegal to deny the Holocaust because some things happened. Some things are true. Some things are so incredible that they defy credibility. So it's easy to then start to believe an alternative universe because you just cannot believe that 6 million Jews were marched into the ovens. And sure enough, what has gone on over the past several decades is we now have Holocaust deniers. They deny that the Holocaust either actually happened or that it was as bad as it really was. Holocaust denying 101 is to say not as many Jews died as 6 million. That number is probably more than 6 million Jews. And at the beginning, you know, when they first unraveled the Holocaust and found out what really happened, they were Americans and the French and even the Germans and the British were smart enough to say, nobody's going to believe this. Nobody is going to believe this story. And they will choose to forget it or rewrite it. And over time, that is what has happened. People have said, well, it wasn't really 6 million. The numbers were inflated. Friday was Holocaust Remembrance Day. And the President Bannon, issued a statement on Holocaust Remembrance Day. And it left out the fact, I'm laughing because it's just so absurd, it left out the fact that 6 million Jews were incinerated during the Holocaust. Hope Hicks, one of the spokesmen for President Bannon, said that they did that on purpose, that they intentionally left out the 6 million Jews because 5 million other people were exterminated, including priests, gypsies, people with mental or physical deformities, communists, trade unionists, Jehovah's Witnesses, anarchists, Poles, and other Slavic people, as well as resistance fighters. Hope Hicks, a spokesman for President Bannon, said, it was our honor to issue a statement in remembrance of this important day, but to mention the 6 million Jews, we would have been neglecting the priests, gypsies, people with mental or physical disabilities, communists, trade unionists, Jehovah's Witnesses, anarchists, Poles, and other Slavic peoples, and resistance fighters. If you go to a Holocaust museum, and I think in 2 years there will be a Holocaust museum in every city in America, you will be reminded that it wasn't just 6 million Jews, that there were other people who were killed in the Holocaust. But here's the difference. And this is why you have to mention 6 million Jews. 6 million priests were not exterminated. 6 million gypsies were not exterminated. Six people with mental or physical deformities were not exterminated. 6 million Poles, Polish people, were not exterminated. 6 million resistance fighters were not exterminated. 6 million Jews were exterminated. And Hitler rose to power promising to take care of the Jews. So when you talk about the Holocaust, you have to include the 6 million Jews. When you talk about the Holocaust, you have to include the 5 million priests, gypsies, people with mental or physical deformities, communists, trade unionists, Jehovah's Witnesses, anarchists, Poles, and Slavic people, and resistance fighters. That is how you remember the Holocaust. Every president on Holocaust Remembrance Day has made sure to do that, except President Bannon. The reason he's banning Muslims is they are Semites. The reason he hates Jews, the reason President Bannon hates Jews, is because they are Semites. The reason President Bannon supports Netanyahu and Israel is he wants the Semites to be in Israel, not here, because President Bannon hates Semites. Arabs are Semites. Jews are Semites, and President Bannon hates Semites. That's not an alternative fact. 6 months ago in the Times of Israel, they went over President Bannon's long history of anti-Semitism. One of the things President Bannon did was he went after Ann Applebaum, a Washington Post columnist. He accused her of orchestrating attempts, quote, to impose a globalist worldview upon citizens that reject it. That's classic anti-Semitism, globalist worldwide views. He said she's in the pocket of George Soros, a favorite target, Jewish target among the alt-right. And the column in Breitbart that President Bannon ran included the sentence, "Hell hath no fury like a Polish Jewish American elitist scorned." President Bannon, running Breitbart, then failed to remove the anti-Semitic comments under this column that was attacking the Washington Post and Applebaum. One of the comments included Heil Hitler. Somehow that was not removed from Breitbart, run by President Bannon at the time. The Times of Israel reports about President Bannon's divorce. In 2007, President Bannon's ex-wife said under oath that her then-husband was an anti-Semite who made repeated anti-Semitic remarks, especially when they were choosing a school for their daughters in Los Angeles. Bannon was picking schools in Los Angeles for his daughters, and he asked one of the directors of the schools, quote, "Why are there so many Hanukkah books in the library?" At another school, Bannon reportedly looked around at the school and said, "Was this place a temple? This feels like a temple." At a third school, the Archer School for Girls, Bannon went on to say that the biggest problem he had with Archer, the school for girls, is the number of Jews that attend. He said he doesn't like Jews. This is from the divorce deposition. The wife said, "My husband at the time doesn't like Jews, and that he doesn't like the way they raise their kids to be, quote, whiny brats, and that he didn't want the girls going to school with Jews." That's why President Bannon's Holocaust Remembrance Declaration did not include the extermination of 6 million Jews. That's why on the same day that this Holocaust Declaration Remembrance was issued, he issued a ban on Muslims entering this country. While at Breitbart, President Bannon gave an interview with Mother Jones, and he said that Breitbart is the platform for the alt-right. Now, the alt-right, we hear this term a lot. You all know what the alt-right is. It is a movement that is now in the White House that believes in white European pride. It promotes white nationalism. It is openly racist. It is openly Islamophobic and openly anti-Semitic. So the Muslim ban has been sort of kind of overturned, maybe, maybe not. The protests have been tremendous and heartwarming. Go to your airport, go online, find out where you can make your voice heard. Go to 5calls.org, the number 5calls.org. They will give you the script and the phone number. It takes 5 minutes to make 5 calls each day. You'll not only save our republic, you'll feel good. You'll be channeling your rage, your paranoia, your anxiety into something positive and good. I'm very proud of organized religion here in the United States. So far, the only Christian who spoke out in favor of Trump's ban was Franklin Graham, the son of Billy Graham. I don't know how many of you remember Billy Graham, but he was caught on tape in the Nixon White House spewing anti-Semitic vitriol, like father, like son of a bitch. Yeah, you should just Google that or on YouTube, look up Billy Graham whining to Richard Nixon on the White House tapes about Jews. Billy Graham, a noted anti-Semite. He's still alive. He's pushing 100, Billy Graham. He's still alive because God doesn't want him. A lot of Jews in private say to me, well, yeah, Steve Bannon, President Bannon is an anti-Semite, but we're safe. We're safe. The Jews are safe. Not, look, by the way, 80% of American Jews voted for Hillary. But, you know, 20% of Jews are thinking, well, okay, the Muslim ban is bad. It's wrong. I hope even those 20% of the Jews are thinking that. I don't know. But this is what the Jews are thinking in the back of their head. Yes. Yes. There's anti-Semitism in the Oval Office right now. But President Bannon, his guy Trump, his daughter Ivanka, is married to a Jew, Jared Kushner. Jared Kushner will save us. I've actually heard people say this. Trump's grandchildren, Ivanka, converted to Judaism. Yes, and she makes love through a hole in the very same sheet that her dad wears at his rallies, which are apparently rubber sheets, by the way, because he likes Russian hookers to pee on him, which isn't true. But you know what? Let's just say it is. Let's just say it is. So the Jews are saying, well, you know, Jared's Jewish. He married Ivanka. She converted. So the grandchildren are Jewish and they're being raised Jewish and they're not, you know, they belong to a temple and they on Saturdays, they don't work. First of all, Ivanka's conversion by Rabbi Lookstein will not be accepted in Israel because Rabbi Lookstein is a That's the first thing. Secondly, Jared Kushner isn't running the show. Trump isn't running the show. Steve Bannon is running the show. President Bannon is running the show. That's a lot of responsibility to place on Jared Kushner to think that he's going to save the Jews. You know, he's not Esther. I don't know if you're familiar with the story of Purim, but Jared Kushner is no Esther. Anybody dumb enough to marry Ivanka Trump will believe Steve Bannon when Steve Bannon says, hey, I'm not anti-Semitic. if you're stupid enough to bed, marry, and propagate with Ivanka Trump and marry into the Trump family, then you're stupid enough to believe that Steve Bannon isn't anti-Semitic when he tells you he isn't. Jared Kushner is not Esther. I don't know if you know the story of Purim. It's actually a book in the Bible, so it's the book of Esther, an actual book from the Old Testament. Esther is a beautiful Jewish woman living in Persia, kind of like Jared Kushner, right? Esther was taken into the house of the king of Persia to become part of his harem, and the king fell in love with Esther more than any of his other women, and he made Esther the queen, but he didn't know that Esther was a Jew, and so Haman, he's the egotistical advisor to the king, the power behind the king, Haman, that's who Steve Bannon is. Steve Bannon is Haman. Haman wanted to kill all the Jewish people. Esther, the beautiful queen, was able to save the Jews because she was good and Haman was bad. Well, Jared Kushner is Esther and Steve Bannon is Haman. But I got news for you. Jared Kushner is no Esther, okay? Steve Bannon, the power behind the king, is Haman. Leave it to the anti-Semitic Trump people working under Steve Bannon to find America's only dumb Jew. There's one dumb Jew in America, and it's Jared Kushner, who married Ivanka Trump. Because as I said, only a dumb Jew would marry into the Trump family. Yes, Jared Kushner went to Harvard. We all know that, so we think he's smart. But The Guardian talks about a new book by Daniel Golden, which says that Kushner got into Harvard only because, according to this book, only because his father, Jared Kushner's father, donated $2.5 million to Harvard. This is in a book that came out. It's actually not a new book. It came out about 12 years ago. It's called The Price of Admission. Came out in 2006. It's about the trend of rich Americans buying their idiot children into prestigious universities. Golden interviewed Jared Kushner's peers and his teachers, and the administrators at the high school that Jared Kushner attended said they were stunned to discover that he got into Harvard. They described him as, quote, a less than stellar student. Not only did Jared Kushner not work for his wealth, it's all inherited wealth, his own father was sending checks in his name to candidates illegally. You would think, you know, if you're smart enough, supposedly, to get into Harvard, you would keep an eye on your checking account, but not Jared Kushner. Why bother when you have inherited wealth? Your father can donate $2.5 million and buy your way into Harvard, or donate money to the Democratic Party the way Charles Kushner did, so that Ted Kennedy, one of the good guys, Ted Kennedy, made a call to Harvard on behalf of Jared Kushner. And then, surprise, surprise, Jared Kushner got into Harvard. Meanwhile, while Jared Kushner was taking up space that he didn't belong at Harvard, his idiot, immoral father, Charles Kushner, went to prison because of the phony checks that he was sending to candidates to buy influence. His brother-in-law had turned state's evidence. And to shut him up, what Jared Kushner's father, Charles Kushner, did is he hired a prostitute. He paid her $10,000 so he could videotape his brother-in-law having sex with the prostitute, then take that tape to the wife and bribe the brother-in-law not to turn state's evidence. Well, turns out Charles Kushner was even a bigger idiot because he got caught and did even more time in prison because of that. That's who Jared Kushner's father is. That's who Jared Kushner is. He's not successful. All he does is he gravitates to wealth. Immoral, stupid, not Esther. Polyester, because he's fake, but he's not Esther.
Hey, we're all out of time. There's another 3 hours of this. Go to DavidFeldmanShow.com. Talk to you next week.